Let's hot reload it and check if we are getting any error or not. No, we are not getting any error. If I click on the item number 2, you can see here that item number 2 is written. If I click on item number 3, you can see that item number 3 is here, item number 1 is here. And now I am going to discuss some more property. So the next property is icon size. The default icon size is 24.0, and you can increase it or decrease it. So I am going to first increase it to 40 and hot reload it, and you can see that the icon size has been increased. Let's update to 60. So the icon size has been increased, and if I make it 10.2, and the icon size is not visible now, it's looking like a dot. So let's change it to bit higher, like 40 was good. So this is our icon size, and now what I am going to show you that is there any property elevation. The default elevation is 8 and the maximum elevation is 16 and the minimum elevation is 0. So if you want to hide the elevation, like if you can see that here is the elevation in this drop down list, and now I put it to 0 and I hot reloaded it, and now if I open this, you can see there is no elevation. If I change it to 1 and hot reload it, and if I select this, there is very less elevation, but there is elevation because I had selected 1. And now I am going to select the highest value, which is 16, and this is a maximum elevation which can be have to a drop down list. So I hope that you got the idea about the elevation also. And the next property is style. I am not going to touch this because it's a text style, and everybody know about this. Each dense, I am also not going to touch this, and key, I am also not going to touch that. So I hope that you got the idea about the drop down, and I think I am forgetting something that I promised you in the beginning, that I will show you something at the end. So I am just cut this code, and now I am going to use this new drop down hide underline button. So let's paste the code here and format it. Remember one thing, currently I had not hot reloaded the code. So you can see that here is a underline. Here is a underline, and now I put the code in code of this drop down button inside our widget, which is called as drop down button hide underline. So I had wrapped this drop down button inside this drop down hide underline. Now if I hot reload it, it will hide the underline. Let's zoom it. Now you can see that the underline has been hidden, and you are not seeing any underline. And this is the how you can hide the underline. So I hope that you got the idea that how you can do this. And I am going to show one more thing, that I think it is quite difficult for you to make a list like this. It is a very lengthy, like if you have some 10 to 12 item and you have to write the numbers, very long code. So for that I am going to write a function, a small function, and that will map the list. Let's see this list string and drop equal to and here will be item 1 comma copy paste item 2 3 4 and 5, and this one is 6, this one is last. Okay, we have now 6 string, a list of string which is having the 6 item. And instead of writing these much code, I am going to solve this issue by one line of code. List drop equals to drop dot map, and for each string, for for each value I want to return I want to just return what? New drop-down menu, drop-down menu item, and there will be a child, and that child will be a new text. I am just following the code from the below. New text, and that text will be val, which is passing here val. So just after this child, there will be a value, and that will be also val. And control alt and l to format this code. Sorry, I had pressed the wrong key. Full screen and close this one. So now I am going to press this alt control and l to format this code, and I think it's done now. But I think I am forgetting something. I need to convert it into a list, because currently that is in not a list, that is in a, I think, yes, that is not in a list. When we will convert it into list, it will be like, you can see here that return type is list, drop down menu item, and string, which is similar to our list drop variable. So now it's done, and we had created a, let's comment this code, and let's rerun the code. And if we will, okay, we are getting some error. Let's see the error. Well, value child, everything is okay. New drop down value equals to null. The value should be not null. Drop down dot drop dot map, and drop dot map for each value. I am, it is saying me that to list I had, let's drop down. I think I need to specify the string here. Yes, and let's rerun this code. I think there is a small mistake that okay, actually I had not specified the type of this list item. I had specified as a string. Now it's fine. And now when I click on this, it is giving me everything. I selected item 6, it is showing item 6. I selected item 4, it is showing item 4. I selected 2, and it is showing the item 2. And I hope that you got the idea that how you can implement this drop down, list drop down in this Flutter. And I think I had discussed almost everything about this drop down, except something like key and some more thing. The reason is that I don't want to discuss that now, and because the video is going very lengthy. And if you got everything what I tried to explain here, please let me know. If you found any issue in understanding any concept, or if you want any video in Flutter or any other technology, please let me know, because I make a video on only request when any user or subscriber or any friend of any of my friend request me for any tutorial video, then only I make the video. So thank you.